What is up, you guys? This is Mick with Fresh on the Flea, and I'm here bringing you guys a new video. Tell you guys, thank you for the support that you guys are giving me. A happy Thanksgiving. Like I said, it's not possible without the support and views and likes and everything you guys give me. So I want to say thank you again. So there's going to be a new giveaway, some other like product stuff going on. So keep that in mind and stay tuned. As well as that, you know, a lot of people do ask me, do I sell my stuff? And yes, I do. Remember, link is down below. Check out the Depop. With that, I've been going back and forth. Should I do a Black Friday deal or should I do a Cyber Monday? So Cyber Monday is coming. So keep that in mind. Deals, steals, it's going to be crazy. Talk about support. If you guys are loving the videos and you want me to make more, remember, do hit that like button. It just really does help me a lot. And as well as that, do hit that subscribe button if you're not already, and also hit that bell button if you want to see when I upload immediately. Like I said, it puts you in the line so you never miss a video. I implore you, don't miss out. You know what that means?
Just in here straight away, like always. Women's section startup. Just had to. I don't know what it is. Just gotta check out some of this stuff over here because I never get to. Right? Men's section come up, but in the women's section, it's a size large, triple A. Tombstone, Arizona, the legend lives. You guys know the OK Corral. If you guys have a chance and you're in LA, go check out the Gene Autry Museum. You can actually see his Wyatt Earp's actual Colt pistol. It's amazing. It's like this long, the barrel of it. It's just insane. You can see a lot of the weapons that were used there. And yeah, keep the legend alive. We be jamming, man. Look at that. New Orleans. What happened? What happened to Jamaica? Look, this is a Zara man piece. Check this one out. Look at the, looks like vintage Nike to me. I don't know. Hungry. San Miguel Pale Pilsen. Oh man, they even got the print right on the back. Shout out to my Filipino boys over here. Oh my gosh. Finally at the spot. Remember, do I have to remind you? No. $3.99 hats. Let's do it. Who doesn't get a little shwasted every once in a while, right? Thank you, Pabst. So the double hat fury I did find, yes, in the Caps, where the undefeated, what's this right here? Yeah, undefeated, like, camel cap, and as well as the Marmont Mountain dad cap. One size fits all. I don't know. I'll check them out. This one's a little worn for wear, but this one's pretty clean. You guys already know what I'm seeing right here. Oh my gosh, it's him. It's him, it's Ernie. Look at that. Let's see, any trades? Yes, I see right there. Muppets Incorporated. I'm thinking the 70s on this one. Look at his hands, man. That's crazy. How much they want? $5. Don't mind. It's yummy. It's yummy. Couple of M&Ms over here. Don't see the age for some reason. I don't get it. See the football one. They do have the couch potato. No pun intended, right? This. What is this? What does it shoot out? Is this a water gun? No, it's a water gun. Not the right season, man. Do they have in the mugs? I see Carl's name right there. Rest in peace, Carl. Walking Dead fans, where are you at? Del? Taco or not? Huh? I see a Google sack right here. Check out the industrial staple gun. Might have to pick this one up. The guam fish. What is this? What is that? What is that? Oh my gosh, what is this? What? Oh my gosh, okay, I'm getting out of here. That was pretty scary. I don't know what that was about. The TV's like freaking out too. I think it's a weird one right there. Not dealing with it. Mm-mm, not here, not today. Look what I stumbled upon. Look at this little baby skateboard over here. Let's see if I can do some crazy trick. Let's see, 360 flip right here. Boom. That's how I do it. So let's get in the tees. Yeah, check out this long sleeve right here. It's by Maverick. You guys know Logan Paul brand. In the mix. Who wants to go to Japan? Come on. Great little Tommy scoop up right here. Tommy, little nice little pocket flag right here. It's not bad. Look, finding something that's hidden. It's funny. Got over here in the pants, but check it out. They have a little bit that newer gets. There's the patch. I'd love to see it. Looking in the CDs like always, but I do come up every once in a while on some PlayStation discs. Now, these are crazy because I saw my PlayStation and I still do rock them, so I am gonna have to pick these ones. Look at this Casper. I don't know about the cool borders, the bowling looks pretty cool. I don't know about these, but Casper is a must, and I'm still looking. Let's see what they got. Don't you remember? Because I remember. Look what I just found. You see it? Sir Mix-a-Lot baby got back right here. Look what he's standing on. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, 1992 Cake Boy. What's up, Cake Boy? That's a definite pickup. Gotta love this section, man. Gotta love it. You know, I got everything I can get. Taking off. Let's go.
So let's get in the recap straight off, you guys. So yes, I did pick up the Marmont cap. I do have a few jackets, and I know the jackets go for crazy amount of money, but I've never found a hat. Always find the TNF, Columbia, all these, and I found this hat. So this one was $3.99, and again, it's in super clean condition. That's the thing. Anytime you find hats, do check the sweatband for condition. Usually you can tell because the tag. Sweat does accumulate around white tags, material tags. Sweatband, the name itself, sweatband, you can tell. But in this case, super clean. Just have the little Marmont tag right there on the back, and then check it out, $3.99. Why not? This one's a crazy piece because it's in orange. I've seen this shirt, exact shirt, in both red and blue. And the fact that I came up on the orange one, like I said, this is very plaid. What it has going for it is that pocket flag right there. You guys can see right there, the pocket flag, like I said. Other than that, it's got a little flag patch on the back. Does have the Tommy Jeans patch in there. It's a size large, a little oversized, you can see. And I was gonna see that baggy look from the time, right? This one was $4.99. I didn't mind picking it up, like I said. A lot of this stuff you find has like the sweat stains in the armpits. When you find something this clean, you can actually see it's still pleated. Why not pick it up? Let's go back to my older videos, right? Tommy Hilfiger swag. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, that's a little time capsule for you guys. If you guys remember the old videos, that's what I used to say all the time. I found a few PlayStation games. I never find PlayStation games. I should have picked up the two. I might go back when they open up again to pick those two up, the bowling and the Cool Borders 3. Casper, when it first came out, big movie for me. Loved the whole aspect of it. Casper the Friendly Ghost, right? And he's living with his like uncles, Fatso, Stretch, Stinky. And that is just crazy because I did come up on a lamp right before Halloween came. I didn't even put the pictures up. I still have it in the room. It's got a, literally an MTV cap like sitting on it. You guys remember Casper when it came out? It got the Pizza Hut like sponsorship. So Pizza Hut was doing all those things. I had the little weird puppets and everything. He said, this is going back to my childhood right here. And that's why nostalgia is taking me over. Problem with a lot of these, you'll buy them and the disc is completely scratched. This one had a few scratches in it, but guess what? It played. That's what matters. They did tax a little bit on this one. They charged it $3.99 because it was a game. The girl at the front that actually rang me up almost didn't believe that this was $3.99. She thought it was cheaper and she almost did it, but her manager was right behind her And she's like, yes, because it's a game. And I was like, oh, okay, whatever. Because I knew how much it was going to be already. I know the games go for like that. But I don't mind picking these up. It's gotta love Casper. Now, on to this. Wow, I was surprised finding it. And yes, it's in there. Because when you find this stuff and it's got the cover, but it doesn't have the actual cassette, that's a bummer. And the fact that this thing is super clean. Sir Mix-a-Lot's cassette tape, Baby Got Back. If that's not classic, I don't know what is. 1992, you guys. 1992, and it says Baby Got Back, Cake Boy. That is just crazy. It is programmed, arranged, mixed, produced, and engineered by Sir Mix-a-Lot. Guitars by Michael Powers. So that's insane, the fact that he is everything on this. There we go, right here. That's the reason why. Sticker came off completely, didn't damage anything. Look how clean this thing is. I'll be showing a little more pictures right there because you got to see how the cleanliness of this thing, the fact that it wasn't all smashed and everything. The thing about the cassettes, they're only like 49 cents each. So the guest box that I have here every once in a while actually is a cassette holder. It has a bunch of cassettes in there. That's the thing. I found that one at the same thrift. I just love collectible stuff, and the fact that this is Baby Got Back, this is why I do what I do. Gotta love the cake. So last but not least, and I'm gonna say the cop of the day for various reasons, the Bert and Ernie collectible. Ernie puppet from 1970. A little history of Bert and Ernie. I'm gonna say both because I can't say one without the other. They were built by Don Salen. He built them off of just a scribble that Jim Henson himself drew about the characters. And he created these Muppets in a certain way that just spoke to him. Going back to your original Sesame Street pilot episode, the first episode to ever be tested in 1969, basically just had Bert and Ernie in it. That's the thing about Bert and Ernie, they are pretty much the real OGs of Sesame Street. So that's why for $4.99, I was definitely gonna pick it up. Yes, you guys, I wanna thank you for watching. Again, like I said, it was not the biggest video ever, but it was basic thrifting coming into a thrift store at the latest of the days and coming up on something that just blew my mind. And like I said, that Muppet find tickled my vintage fancy. And you guys already know, I love my 90s finds right here because look at that. They got Casper, Sir Mix-a-Lot, Baby Got Back, the Tommy, and Marmite on top. Who's ready for the tasty treats? So with that, I'm gonna say what I always say. Hit that sub button because more videos are coming. This was Mick from Fresh from the Flea.